have a few sprinkles in your own backyard by maybe later this evening, and especially tonight, some spotty showers, windy and wet. For Wednesday night, we'll show you the timing of what could be some heavier rain across our area. Lighter rain chances and also lower chances for tonight through Wednesday. Wednesday night and Thursday, almost a guarantee we have rain across the area. But the good news for the weekend, even though it cools down, our rain chances at the moment appear like they stay well to our south across Florida. We'll keep the weekend forecast dry. I mentioned maybe an evening sprinkle or some showers, still a good 50 miles off from the coastline. These will gradually work toward the low country and coastal areas of southeast Georgia. If you live west of I-95, you'll be dry for most of the evening. The forecast as we move forward tonight, mid-40s, that's likely well inland in the northern part of the low country, 50s along the coastline, not as cold tonight, but there will be spotty showers really anytime late evening through the overnight hours. Look at the temperatures now out the door tomorrow morning. We start to warm up slightly after midnight. This will be a nice feel out there in the morning, low to mid 50s across the area. And look what happens. These southerly winds come racing across the area, at least 10 to 20 miles per hour tomorrow. It will be choppy out on the Atlantic, 72 in Savannah, 73 in Pembroke. A little cooler though for the coastal areas. They'll still warm into the 60s. And then we only dip down to probably upper 50s, near 60 for Thursday morning. A cold front comes rushing across the area, so our temperatures will almost be in reverse. Warmest in the morning, coolest by afternoon, and you'll start to feel those winds cool us as we get past the lunch hour. Rain timing now. Here is future cast, 9 p.m. this evening. A spotty sprinkle, maybe a handful of showers. They will become a little more numerous after midnight. This is at 3 a.m., so not far from that. The bus stop for the kids tomorrow morning, maybe a sprinkle, a very brief shower. If they want the umbrella, put it in the backpack. Chances are they won't need it. I would say though, Wednesday night into Thursday morning, if you work third shift, maybe you're up very early out for the morning exercise. Let's talk about the rain timing then. 1 a.m. going into Thursday morning, potential for some pockets of heavier rain that comes sweeping across the area. 5 a.m. out the door then along the I-95 corridor. That's where the heaviest rain is located. Rain starts to wind down Thursday morning, but then we'll have the winds that start to pick up west northwest, and that's why you saw those temperatures falling. Yeah, they will usher in our next cool down that could stick around all the way through the weekend. All right, future rainfall totals a half inch or more. That is mainly Wednesday night and into Thursday across the area. And then by the weekend, it dries out and cools down. The number one question I get from viewers each and every winter, is it going to snow? And this is the one time I can guarantee you it will snow. Hilton Head Snow Day. This is where the kids want to be. Shelter Cove on Saturday. It kicks off at 11 a.m., goes until 4 p.m. Parents, you may not want to play in the snow, but you want to dress warm that day. 40s to low 50s, that's it. All right, in the short term, 70s tomorrow. That's our one day of spring-like weather in the forecast. And then the rain settles in Wednesday night into early Thursday. Maybe even a rumble of thunder. Potential freeze on Saturday morning. And then it stays cool into next week.